and tell you that Ishwar Singh visited my house once when I was working as secretary in the government of the state. And since we knew that he is an old satsangi and he wanted to sleep in the living room and not in a bedroom, guest bedroom. So we opened up the sofa and he slept on that. So I said, I'll sleep there, just give me a pillow. So I was working on some files in my study there. At night it occurred to me, I hope he's comfortable on the sofa. So I opened the door and I saw he was sitting in meditation. I said, boy, he's following the GM's instructions, Great Master's instructions, to meditate for a little bit before sleeping. So I went back to my work. And about 11:30 at night, before I retired, I went to see if he has slept soundly. He was still meditating. So I came back, I couldn't sleep. I said, the man is going on meditating and I'm thinking of sleeping. That's not fair. So I went back after an hour or so, by tossing and turning in the bed. He was still meditating. I went early morning at 3 o'clock. So I couldn't sleep and he was still meditating. I went at 5 o'clock, he was still meditating, and then he got up. I said, doctor, you meditate all night? He said, I don't meditate enough. I said, what do you mean? He said, the reason is that we have a master whom we have not recognized. That's our biggest mistake. We could not recognize him. We thought he was a master. We thought he was a friend. We didn't realize he was Satpurush in a human form. And therefore, the more I meditate, the more I realize the truth of who Great Master was. And I think it's not enough what I do. Such an example that doctor was for us. So that is why I said, meditation can be that important to realize who a master is. One of the things that I used to worry about was that meditation is a mechanical exercise. Even Master himself used to say, Great Master used to say, meditation is not as effective as love and devotion and service. So I used to, you know, sort of downgrade meditation. But after hearing the story from Ishwar Singh himself, I have ranked meditation very high in order to be able to recognize who a master is. We don't recognize. We think he's a very enlightened man. We think he may be a very learned man. Maybe he has done a lot of research into spirituality. Maybe he's a great yogi. Maybe he has reached the highest levels of consciousness, but he's still like us, like a man. We don't realize he's just a human body containing the entire wealth of Sachkhand, containing the entire power of the creator of the universe, sitting in a human body. It's very difficult to know that. But the more we meditate, the more we realize who a master is. And therefore it is a big lesson for me, and now I rank meditation very high.